The Slormancer released patch 0.2. There's good news and there's bad news. The bad news here is that there are a massive number of nerfs. The good news is the devs will now make content again and stop nerfing this game. Oh, and my Bouncing Balls mage build? It still works, I just tested it out. Most of the patch notes were already available as this thing sat on the experimental branch for a couple of weeks, but I chose to wait until the real deal. But now we wait no more, because it has arrived, my fellow Slormers, bringing the nerfs. But first, how about an upgraded game engine which should solve black screen issues and other crashes, as well as less FPS drops? Or some resolutions for resolutions. The game now supports 1440p and 4K resolution, windowed full screen, and gives you the option to change on which monitor the game is displayed. In my initial review about the game, I mentioned that the fonts were really hard to read, and that's been taken care of as well. They are no longer fuzzy and blurry, but nice and sharp. They gave us a few more font options, you can lock the cursor to your screen, and there is the option to hide Slorm, which you automatically pick up just as gold, and that somewhat clutters the screen, so I like that option. The Slormancer introduced pure stats, which are critical rolls of regular stats, meaning they're up to 100% stronger modifiers and they can only be found on loot dropped by enemies or at Gemma's store. I personally think that is a bit of a missed opportunity, because they could have made it drop exclusively from monsters. You could then compare it to exalted items in Last Epoch, and there is a certain charm to that. It makes killing monsters just a bit more exciting when you see the purple font, and I think it is a great mechanic. Having a vendor sell these items as well diminishes that feeling. Crafting has been seriously rebalanced, with the overall goal to make a clear distinction between endgame items and just items for leveling or convenience while grinding. Every craft that has to do with creating pretty much best in slot items, so that's crafts related to reapers, masteries or attributes, has had the gold cost increased by 1000%. Sudden nerf, this one. Adding stats is a bit more expensive as well, but only sees a 60% increase. On the other hand, the more common crafts like rerolling scores and locking stats has been reduced by 60 and 40% respectively. So, what does this mean? Well, basically that you need to be on the lookout for good base items to craft on. It's going to be tremendously expensive to create a god-tier item from scratch. It is still completely fine to do a few rerolls on a decent base, and that's even encouraged with these changes. However, the crafts that give your characters that massive boost, those are now insanely expensive and instantly ported to the realm of endgame crafting. And I think that is perfectly viable. 1000% though. I mean, maybe a bit too much, but the idea is completely justified in my opinion. There's more nerfs though. Reinforcement previously gave a linear 15% increase per reinforcement level, regardless of which level that was. Well, not anymore. There are now diminishing returns, and each reinforcement level now gives 1% less than the previous one. So it still starts at 15% increased power, but after 10 reinforcements it's only 5%. It drops all the way to 1%, which most likely won't be worth it at that point. To remedy the nerfs a bit, reinforcement cost is reduced, but in the long run that clearly doesn't matter, while the diminishing returns hurt a lot. We're not done nerfing people, because there are still loot drops to be nerfed. Pretty much any damage stat and damage reduction stat you can think of has been nerfed by 50%. Another subtle nerf right there. Some stats, mostly those having to do with keeping your character sustained and alive, have been increased by 50%. On top of this, melee, projectile, area of effect and all damage reductions are now kept at 75%. These weren't kept before, they went all the way to 100%, which clearly led to some issues. This change is in line with the changes to crafting, however. The whole process of creating good items is severely hamstringed, and in all fairness, it was too easy. So at least in theory, this makes sense. It can be good for the longevity of the game, because there's a bit more to grind towards. Players were tackling Wrath 10 content way too easily, and that certainly won't be possible anymore now without spending huge amounts of currency or Slorm, Slormite, Slormalite, Slormline, or more Slorm. Unless you have a character already with god tier items, because I noticed that my existing gear, which is very good, isn't changed after the patch. It only seems to apply to newly crafted gear. This will lead to a bit of a gap gap between existing builds and new builds, which I don't think should be the case. The changes I just mentioned, all those nerfs, they are generic and basically apply to everyone and every build. Now we move on to the more specific balancing and nerfing, and this may or may not impact you, depending on what you play. There are a few more balancing changes in the attributes, with some greater traits being swapped around, and whether these are nerfs or buffs depends on the build that you're running. The Ancestral Legacy received a few buffs because this was typically rather weak, specifically Cold Snap, Burning Rage, Scorching Earth and Elemental Emergency are buffed. Several Reapers were rebalanced, and here the same thing is true. It will really depend on your build if this is good or not, if this is impacting you at all. So I'm not gonna go over each Reaper and over what changed. I will link everything down below in the description. You can go to this article and read it for yourself. And honestly, the same thing is true for several changes for the classes. It is more of the same, it's just a lot of rebalancing. Across the board, we see mana cost increases, however, sometimes up to 300%. And a special mention goes out to the clones of the mage, which are now consuming your mana when they're casting skills. That is likely to kill a few builds out there. Mana sustain, especially with the buffed values, this patch shouldn't be too hard, however. And Anodon projectiles, they can no longer fork and pierce at the same time. It's one or the other. Then, a good change for the newer players. Each character gets a little bit of health regen at level 1. The start of the campaign was often brutal because you didn't regenerate health at all and you often relied on leveling up to get back your health until you finally found that health regen modifier on an item. Those are issues from the past, and this is a nice newbie friendly addition to the game. Gaining mastery gets easier the higher level you are because you get a permanent 2% bonus per level, and whenever a skill gains mastery, other equipped skills will gain a small portion of mastery as well. This is a good change. I want to share a few thoughts on this overall nerf fest, but first I would like to hear your opinion on all of this. Did these guys go overboard here with 1000% nerf to crafting cost? I'm curious, so let me know in the comments. And here's what I think. I do think that the devs maybe went a little bit overboard here and they're turning the Sloremancer into some sort of grind fest, and I'm not sure that is what this game needs right now. I understand the desire to reduce the power level of players significantly because new content is in the making with new dungeons and zones and all, and we shouldn't be able to just steamroll all of that. That makes perfect sense. I do want to point out though that the Sloremancer isn't Path of Exile and the massive grind isn't what I want to see out of this game. I want the Sloremancer to be fun and offer progression for maybe up to 100 hours, and I feel at that point there's a decent chance most people have had a great time with it and then they just put it down. I think it's important that a small game like this doesn't overstay its welcome. Chronicon does a good job there. Sure, there are undoubtedly people with 1000 hours into that game, but honestly, there are people with 1000 hours into any game, it really doesn't mean anything. But typically, Chronicon is a game you play for a while. You feel the progression, you mess around in the endgame, and then you're done. It's like after 100 hours or so. I think that's a fair estimate. It is not overly grindy, and it is well balanced. Let's hope these Sloremancer changes don't take too much enjoyment out of the game, because what we still didn't get is new content. I'm going to wait for new stuff to arrive to return, however, to this one, because I've seen what the Sloremancer has to offer at this point. Patch 0.2 in that regard didn't bring anything new, only nerfs. And that is not inherently bad. I can see the reasoning. Like I said, patch 0.3 should have plenty of new content though, according to the devs. The Sloremancer is still definitely worth playing and buying if you haven't. It is a super promising early access game. This is just a more critical video on what seems to be a bit of a knee-jerk reaction to people killing endgame Wrath 10 too easily. If you have any questions or remarks, put them in the comments down below, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did and you want more like this, consider liking the video or even subscribing. It really helps me out. And if you really like the video and you want to support the channel, you can grab a YouTube membership for $2, which gives you absolutely nothing. It's just for love and support. You can also check out my Nexus store, there's a link in the card in the description, where I'm selling a few of my favorite games. And if you buy those, I get a small cut. It doesn't have the Sloremancer yet though, but maybe at release. Thanks for watching and for making it to the end. Love you all. See you soon. Bye bye.